The initial amount of a substance is 290 grams. The half-life of the substance is 8 days. Choose the correct equation for the amount of substance remaining A after T number of days. Let's first of all make a table of values to get a better understanding of the situation. I'm going to use the variables T, H, and A. T is the number of days, H is the number of half-lives, and A is the amount. Now we're given that the initial amount of a substance is 290 grams. That means that when time is equal to zero, the amount is 290. Now when time is equal to zero, the number of half-lives is also zero. The amount is 290 grams. Next, we're told the half-life of the substance is 8 days. So we'll use 8 for our next value of T. 8 days is equivalent to 1 half-life. To determine the amount, we take half of 290, which is 145. After another 8 days, the amount will be cut in half again. So we add 8 to 8, and that gives us 16. 16 days is 2 half-lives. And half of 145 is 72.5. Our goal is to write A as a function of T, but let's first of all write A as a function of H. Notice that as H goes up by 1, the A value is being cut in half. The A value is being multiplied by 1/2. That means that A is an exponential function of H. An exponential function has the form y is equal to c times a to the x, where c is the initial quantity and a is either the growth or the decay factor. In our case, the initial amount is 290 and the decay factor is 1/2. So a is equal to 290 times 1/2 to the h. Now we'll try to write a formula for H in terms of T. Notice that as T goes up by 8, H goes up by 1. Therefore, H is a linear function of T. A linear function has the form y is equal to mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the initial quantity. In this case, the initial quantity is 0, and the slope is 1 over 8. The h values are going up by 1, the t values are going up by 8, so the slope is 1 over 8. Therefore, h is equal to 1/8 of t plus 0. You might also notice that we can just take the value of t and divide by 8. 0 divided by 8 is 0. 8 divided by 8 is 1. 16 divided by 8 is 2. So we can simplify our function to h is equal to t divided by 8. Now we're ready to write our equation for a in terms of t. Notice that we have a in terms of h, and we've got h in terms of t. So we can just substitute t over 8 for h in the first equation. That gives us a is equal to 290 times 1/2 raised to the t over 8. We see that b is the correct answer. We can use a graphing calculator to verify that. First of all, we go to y equals to enter our equation. In the given equation, a is the dependent variable and t is the independent variable. On our calculator, we use y to represent the dependent variable and x to represent the independent variable. So we'll enter y1 is equal to 290 times 1/2 raised to the x over 8. Now when you're raising 1/2 to the x over 8, make sure that you put the x over 8 in parentheses. Otherwise, the calculator will raise 1/2 to the x power and then divide the result by 8. Now that we've entered the equation, we want to make sure that the equation produces the correct table of values. So we'll go to second window, which is table set. We'll start the table at time is equal to 0, and then we'll increment by 8 because the half-life is 8 days. Make sure that the independent and dependent variable are both on auto. Next, go to the table, which is second graph. Notice that the table that is produced matches the table that we created initially. As the x values go up by 8, the y values are being cut in half. The half-life of the substance is 8 days, and the initial amount is 290 grams.